Hi there! Thank you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. Obviously, wala ako sa office ko or sa room ko right now. I'm actually at the airport, but I wanted to make something while I'm waiting for my flight para sa inyo. Now, this lesson is actually something na helpful whether you're taking the UCAT, the LAE, the LET exam, PhilSat, or civil service exam. And this video is about yung shadow. Okay? Yung shadow question na kayo, yan kasi laging lumalabas din. And most people don't know what to do with it. There are two options on how you can solve it, and I'm going to show you what those two options are, and hopefully you can pick out which one is easier for you. Alright, so in order for me to show you better, I'm going to switch over to my PC. I'll see you in a bit.
Alright, so we're going to talk about yung shadow problems. We're going to use the ratio method for that. In order for me to show you kung ano yung solution yan, I'll give you a sample problem. Now, here's a sample problem nung pinag-usapan natin. Sabi, a 150-foot tall building casts a 45-foot shadow. At the same time of day, a tree casts a 3-foot shadow. How tall is the tree? Now, when you have this problem, you have to first understand kung ano yung pinag-uusapan doon sa problem na ito. Ngayon, ang ibig sabihin lang yan is kung kunyari, ito yung building. If you have a building na ito siya, siya ay daw ay 150 feet ang kanyang taas. Okay? Ang kanyang shadow, okay, which is dito naman sa lupa, ang shadow niya is 45 feet. Ngayon, meron kang namang puno at the same time of day, ibig sabihin magkatabi lang sila. Okay, so dahil hindi naman natin malalagay dito, kunyari na lang dito. Okay, may puno ka dyan. Yung puno naman, hindi natin alam kung gano'n siya kataas. It casts a 3-foot shadow. Dyan. Okay, so again, hindi na importante yung accuracy ng lines, hawag nyo na sukatin, hindi naman yung pag-usapan natin. But the concept here is this, okay? Kung nandito ang araw, okay, at umiilaw, sumisinag siya dyan, yung tama ng liwanag here, okay, pababa dyan, yun yung mag-perform ng shadow. This is actually a triangle, if you look at it, okay? So, meron kang triangle na yan. Meron kang triangle right here. And since ang tama ng araw sa kanila ay parehong oras, ibig sabihin nun, they are similar triangles. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Yung ratio nito, ito, ay the same dito. The same sila na right triangle. At dahil pareho sila ng point of reference ng sun, pareho rin sila ng angles na ito. Kung ano yan, same nito. Kung ano to, same nito. Now, what you can do would be, you can either get the, ito yung first method na ginagamit ng iba. But I don't suggest that you do this kasi nakakaubos ng time. Ang ginagawa ng iba is, they use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay. To find the measurement nitong hypotenuse, okay? And then, they use that relationship to compare dito sa small triangle. However, I don't suggest that you do that kasi ang tagal ng oras. Kasi, dun pala sa Pythagorean theorem, baka tumagal na kayo ng mahabang-mahaba. Tapos, ikaw-compute nyo pa dito sa kabila. So, what do we do? You use ratio instead, okay? Now, to give you a point of reference, ang magiging equation natin dito, okay, is going to be like this. Okay, so you have the building again, and kunyari na lang, ganyan, the shadow, this is 150, this is 45, the tree, and yung kanyang shadow na 3 feet. Okay? Ngayon, ganito lang ang gagawin natin. Ratio yan. Kung 150 ang shadow, eh, ang building, ang shadow niya ay 45, equal yan sa 3, kung ano yung 3, height ng 3, which is, hindi natin alam, kaya yun yung x. Tapos yung shadow ng 3, which is 3. Okay, so 3 and shadow. Building is to shadow, 3 is to shadow. Ang importanteng tandaan, again, tapat-dapat tayo. Kung ano yung mga shadow, magkatapat sila. Pag naging fraction to, this will be 150 over 45 is equal to x over 3. And then you can solve for that. Okay? Now, again, I'm suggesting that you use the ratio rotation technique natin. If you haven't seen that, go and watch that first. The reason why I'm going to suggest that you do this is because if you don't do that, you're going to use cross multiplication. It will give you an equation, a 150 times 3 is equal to x times 45, and then you're going to solve pa kayo dyan. Pero if magaling kayo sa ratio rotation, ang mangyayari lang is ilo-lowest terms lang natin siya. 150 tsaka 45, pwede pa ilo-lowest terms. Pareha silang divisible sa 15. So, sa 15, that is 10 and 3. Kung hindi kayang 15, pwede namang 5 muna and then 3. And then you have this. So, you'll be left with 10 over 3 is equal to x over 3. Tapos, to get x, to solve for x, we're just going to do ratio rotation. So, you can start here kasi mas madali. Ikot lang natin siya. 3 divided by 3 times 10 is 3 divided by 3 is 1 times 10 is 10. So, the answer is 10 feet tall yung 3. Again, gaano siya kadali? Mabilis lang siya talaga kasi that's, you use the technique for the same question. I think a problem kasi is that most people don't recognize kung aling problems yung pwede nyong gamitan ng technique. I had a few people tell me that na parang hindi daw nila nagamit masyado yung mga techniques. Pero I have more people telling me na nagamit nila. I think ang problema is the recognition. Kasi for example, sa question na to, kung hindi mo alam na gagamitin siya ng ratio, then you wouldn't know how to answer this. That is why I'm also discussing this. Alright? Now, it's your turn. Okay? Try to solve this. An 18-foot tall tree casts a 6-foot shadow. At the same time of day, a building casts a 44-foot shadow. How tall is the building? Okay, so I'm going to ask you to try it out for yourself. Hit pause now. Alright, let's see how you did. Okay, so meron kang 3. Yung 3 mo daw, taas niya is 18 feet. Ang shadow niya is 6. Meron kang building. Again, hindi natin alam kung gaano kataas. Pero ang shadow niya is 44 foot shadow. So, anong gagawin natin dito? Again, ratio lang siya. 18 is to 6, 3 is to shadow, is equal to the building, which is x, kasi natin alam kung anong taas niya, is to 44, which is the building is to shadow. So, sa fraction, 18 over 6 is equal to x over 44. And then, we're going to do ratio rotation. Now, before we do that, you can put this in lowest terms. Pero since madali naman yung 18 divided by 6, kahit hindi na, no? Simula natin siya dito. 18 divided by 6, 6, 12, 18, that is 3 times 4, 44. So, tatlong 40, which is going to give us 120, plus 12, that's going to give us, plus 12, that's going to give us 132. So, the answer is 132. Feet. Again, what I did there, okay, is just a mental math technique, no? So, when you multiply 44 times 3, pwedeng 40 times 3 plus 4 times 3. Okay? So, that is just 120 plus 12. Yun yung ginawa ko, kaya lumabas yung 132. Okay? Again, you can do it naman ng long cut kung gusto nyo. Pwede namang 44 times 3, ganyan. Pwede rin naman, carry-carry. Kaya lang ako kasi mas preferred ko yan. Alright?
Alright, I hope you learned something new today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure that you share this video with your friends, lalo na kung mag-exam din sila. And if you are taking the OCAT this 2017, I actually have a special surprise for you guys on October 14 sa Horizon Ministries, sa kanilang bagong location in Cubao. Quezon City is right across TIP. You can attend that event. It's actually for free. Ang bayad lang is 50 pesos for the materials and the handouts that you're going to use. It's a whole day event. It's going to be from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. And all you need to do is to sign up to register. You can click on the link na nasa the description box below. And that way, malalaman namin kung ilang tao on that day. We'd love to see you there. Again, this is for free. So if you have any friends or meron kayong mga anak, kapatid, pinsan, kapitbahay na mag-uupkat or mag-take ng Science High School Entrance Exam, as long as they're going to take the test this year, they can attend that free review October 14. Alright? As always, if you want more, subscribe to the channel. Click like if you like this. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon if you want to know as soon as a new video posts. And if you have any questions, you want to reach out to me directly, go to www.facebook.com. facebook.com/teamlyqa. Alright, thank you guys for watching. Bye for now.